I'm Holly Lucas, customer agronomist with Dow Seeds, and today we're going to talk about western bean cutworm. We're out in a corn field. This is a corn plot, so we've got different maturities in here, but we're just about to tassel. We're about a week away from tasseling, and that's a good time to start talking about and thinking about western bean cutworm. Western bean cutworm starts out as a moth. The moth hatches out of the soil in June or July, and they mate and they lay eggs in your corn. And the pest for corn is the larvae that hatch out of those eggs. They can crawl into your ear and cause some damage through the rest of the growing season. One life cycle per season for these moths, so you really just have to worry about that one egg mass. And this is kind of the critical time when we need to be out scouting and then going forward, the worms will cause problems if they're not controlled in your field. So we're here and we're going to look at a western bean cutworm moth trap that we've had out for about 3 weeks. And our grower comes here and checks the trap once a week to see if he's caught any moths overnight. So this is our western bean cutworm trap that we set up. It's a very simple little green trap that you can buy. And it has a couple of parts. First part, it has a lure in the top. So this is a pheromone lure. So it's a lure of female scent hormones that attract male moths into the trap. And you need to change these every 3 weeks. They do run out of smell. And it's a simple little container you put it in. You put the lure in the top of the trap. And then as the moths fly, male moths will fly into the area, they'll go into the trap and they get caught. We have an insecticide strip in the bottom of the trap that kills the moths, and you can come generally once a week and check how many moths you have. Once we get into peak moth flights, you can get up to 200, 500 moths in a week in a trap. So in those heavy areas, we have some growers that are checking once a day to see how many moths they get. It's a little easier to count. So when you're IDing your moths, there's three things you need to look for. There's a little crescent-shaped white spot on the wing, there's a little white dot beside it, and there's a white strip on top of that right along the edge of the wing. When you use the insecticide strips, these are specially designed to fit in the trap. You can also just get an ortho one and cut it small enough to fit in there, but it's easier to ID because the moths are dry. Another way to kill them is put them in antifreeze or something like that, but they're a little harder to ID because they're wet. If you want some more information, you can look on our website, www.dowseeds.ca, or contact your seed partner or myself or any of the other agronomists.